Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I am Maheen Farooq and today we will be talking about chlamydial and rickettsial infections. So these are the two groups of infections that includes further diseases in them. The first one is the chlamydial infections that are basically the exclusively sexually transmitted diseases. And the second one is the rickettsial infections that are the infections that are transmitted to the human host via the animal reservoirs or the insect reservoirs. So the diseases that we will be discussing in today's lecture are the Chlamydia trachomatis infections. So first we will be covering all the infections that include in the chlamydial infections, and then we will be moving towards the rickettsial infections. So see, trachomatis infection is a broad term that further consists of different diseases inside of it, such as trachoma or the genital diseases that involves both male and female. We will be discussing about those diseases, then how they are transmitted from one person to another, what is the pathogenesis and how the pathology works. Okay, now in the heading of C. trachomatis, the first disease that we will discuss is the lymphogranuloma venereum. We will be discussing about that, what lymphogranuloma venereum is, how it manifests inside a human body and how it is transmitted, and its many other features. Then we have trachoma. Now in this disease we will be discussing that mainly that eyes are involved, how they are involved, which structure inside the eye is targeted by the infection, but which area is first disrupted and which is the second target, and how it is the leading cause of blindness in the underdeveloped countries and why underdeveloped countries. We will be discussing about all those these features in the trachoma section. Okay, now the last disease in the chlamydial infection is the chlamydia pneumonia. Chlamydia pneumonia is a disease obviously involving the lungs. How severe it is, how destructive it is to the lungs, is it self-limiting, is it mild, is it severe? We will be discussing all these features and so much more in this part. Now from here on we will be discussing about the rickettsial infections. So the first infection we will be talking about is the Rocky Mountain spotted fever. What are the main characteristics and features of the disease, its pathogenesis, its pathology, and so much more will be discussed. The second disease in the rickettsial infection is the endemic typhus or the loose-borne typhus. The same characteristics will be discussed about this epidemic typhus as well. The third one is the endemic typhus. How the endemic typhus is different from epidemic typhus, what are the basic characteristics, what are the causative agents, all of these will be discussed in this. Then the second last disease is the scrub typhus. What scrub typhus is, how severe it is, and what are the complications it can lead to that it made it having the mortality rate as high as 30%. So all of that will be discussed in the scrub typhus part. The last disease that we will be discussing in the lecture is the Q fever. That what QAD fever is, how it is caused, what are the causative organisms, what is the way of transmission, how it grows and forms its reservoirs in the animals, and what are the ways that from animals it can be transmitted into the humans, and once it has been done, how it is manifested in the human body. So this was all about the introduction of the chlamydial and rickettsial infection, and there are so many more lectures about the pathology that you can find on our website, that is the sqadia.com. So this was all about the introduction of the lecture. Thanks for watching sqadia.com.